and ventilation. First off, before we get into ventilation, let's talk about there's four things in a swine industry that makes the pig productive or can cause improve their chance of livability or cause mortality. What are those four things that you guys can think of that would cause mortality or pigs to thrive? What are those things that could impact that? Any guesses? Feed? Anybody else? Water? Environments? I know these Smithfield guys are all over it. What's the last one? Stockmanship. All right. Now, if you were to rank, what was that, Lori? There you go. If you're to rank those, say from number four through number one, what would you think would be number fourth on that list as far as livability? Probably stockmanship, right? Right? Because, you know, if you don't treat a pig today, yeah, he might live for several weeks, possibly. Hopefully you're treating that pig timely, but that pig can live for a little bit of length of time, right? Also, how you maneuver that pig with the sort board or whatever, obviously lowers the chance risk of that pig dying. Now, what do you think number three is, guys? On that list. Any guesses? Feed. Number three would be feed, yeah? A pig can go without feed for how long, you think? How many? A few days? Yeah, possibly 2 to 3 weeks, possibly. Pig can live without feed. Now, obviously, we're all PQA trained around here, so we want to make sure the pigs have got feed timely, fresh feed. That's very important. But if a pig was to go off feed, he could possibly live for 3 to 4 days. Number two on that list would be what? Water. Yeah, water. So how long do you think a pig could go without water? 2 to 3 days, possibly. Yeah. This guy wants to talk now. So 2 to 3 days is about the length of time a pig can survive without water before water deprivation can set in. So Gat leaves us with old number one. Anybody guess what that one is again? Ventilation, that's right, ventilation. So a pig's ventilation. So how long, if a pig's ventilation isn't properly set, how long potentially could that pig live in an improper environment? Any guesses? 30 minutes to an hour, possibly, if that pig can suffocate that fast. So ventilation is very, very important in making your pig thrive and be productive, okay? So what are some common mistakes that we see in ventilation? How many of you have got curtain-sided facilities? And you might have some holes in that curtain-sided, especially in a tunnel-ventilated barn. You may have this tunnel-ventilated barn, you got holes in the side, now you're pulling this hot air into that barn, add to that heat stress to that pig. Now, if a pig gets hot, how can you tell if a pig's hot? Any guesses? Their respiration rate. That's right. Any guesses? What's a normal respiration rate on a pig? Any guesses? 15 to 25 is a pretty common respiration rate on a pig. And how we determine respiration on a pig is typically you'll want to look at a pig when he's laying down or she's laying down, and when that belly rises up and down, kind of like my belly sometimes does, goes up and down, that takes a good breath, and that's what you want to count. So if you count 15 to 25 breaths in a minute, you know that pig's pretty comfortable. Anything over that 25 is that heat stress is starting to happen, and that pig is stressing out. And if you have a stressed pig, obviously that pig is not going to be performing for you, right? So we want to make sure we get that pig as comfortable as it is. Anything over 40 to 50 respiration rates, we need to take action immediately. Okay? So what are some other ventilations? Well, think about your fans. How often do you clean your shutters and your fans? I assume everybody here has fans. When's the last time you cleaned the shutters on your fans? Yesterday, last week, last month? Every 36 months? However, 6 months. Need to keep your shutters. It's important to keep your shutters clean on your fans. Now, we've got a 36 and a 54-inch here. On our 54-inch fan, it's about a 35,000 CFM fan. But if you don't clean those shutters, then it can reduce your performance of that fan by about 25%. So you're losing 25% of the performance on your fan. So it's important to clean those shutters on a regular basis. Probably most of the time in breeding and gestation is where you commonly would see that. Because you're probably washing your crown houses quicker, I would assume. So, now what about your cones on the back? You ever thought about those? Your cones on the back of your fans also play an important role in your performance of your fan. Because that air is pulling across that cone helps deliver that performance, that air pulling across your fan. hand before even pushing it away. So if your cone is missing or damaged, that affects the performance of your fan. Also causes your barn to get hotter. Guess what? Now your pigs are hotter. Now they're not performing. Not to mention, if your cone's completely missing, now you've got an OSHA violation, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So you want to make sure that cone is on there to protect, you know, your people that's working around it as well. So now, the other thing, typically what you'll see if a pig has become heat stressed or you have ventilation issues is your pig will typically want to lay on the ground. Why do you think they're laying on the ground? Because they're trying to get more body contact to that surface to try to cool off. That gives you another good indication that your pigs could be hot, your ventilation could be bad. What about your inlets? Now, we've got some Val-co inlets right there behind you. On your inlets, what if your inlets are not properly adjusted, or they're not actuated properly, or if you're using a Kirk machine? That also could impact the ventilation in your facilities. What's a good way? Anybody ever in here smoked a barn? I'm not talking about smoked a barn full of pigs. I'm talking about using a fogger system. Come in there and fog your system. And you can apply that fog, and it'll show you where your leaks are in your barn, especially in a tunnel ventilated, or if you got cool cells, it'll show you where those leaks are in your barn. So if you don't own a fogger, they're pretty cheap. You can go to a hardware store, get them pretty cheap. They run on mineral oil, and you can fog your barn, and that'll show you where all your leaks are in your barn. So you'll be surprised when you do that. So I think that's all I'm getting. Got any ventilation questions? I didn't want to get too deep into weeds and take up too much of your time. You got any ventilation questions? You just want the Bass Pro card, right? All right, well, we'll go ahead and draw for that. We need a little kid here, somebody that can't see through glass. anybody, you ladies want a pig? One of you ladies? Everybody get their name in here first off before we draw.
Just go ahead, pick out a name. Go ahead.
Cindy wants to do it, or Brooklyn wants to do it? We'll let Brooklyn do it. She's an Okie, so we trust her, right? Okay, and it's molded even. All right, and our grand prize winner is Cindy McCall. Congratulations, Cindy. Hey, thanks again, folks, for coming by. We'll have another presentation at 2 o'clock. Yeah, give her a hand. We'll have another presentation at 2 o'clock, and I think it's over...
1 o'clock. 1 o'clock.
No, 1 o'clock. I'm sorry. 1 o'clock. And I don't know what I have a random card, but I think it's over the controller.
Yep.
So come by at 1 o'clock, and you'll get another chance to win a Bass Pro card. Hey, Cindy, can we get your picture?